come together today in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace and peace of God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ be with each of you.
And with your spirit.
We have come together to celebrate the sacraments of the anointing and Eucharist. Christ is always present when we gather in his name. Today we welcome him especially as physician and healer. We pray that the sick may be restored to health by the gift of his mercy and made whole in his fullness. And so we pray, Lord, you bore our weakness and carried our sorrows. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You felt compassion for the crowd and went about doing good and healing the sick. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Commanded the apostles to lay their hands on the sick in your name. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us of our sin, and one day bring us to life everlasting.
Amen.
And let us pray. O God, who will that our infirmities be borne by your only begotten Son, show the value of human suffering. Listen in kindness to our prayers for our brothers and sisters who are sick. Grant that all who are oppressed by pain, distress, or other afflictions may know that they are chosen among those proclaimed blessed and are united to Christ in his suffering for the salvation of the world. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
A reading from the letter of James. My brothers and sisters, is anyone among you suffering? He should pray. Is anyone in good spirits? He should sing praise. Is anyone among you sick? He should summon the presbyters of the church, and they should pray over him and anoint him with oil. In the name of the Lord, and the prayer of faith will save the sick person, and the Lord will raise him up. If he has committed any sins, he will be forgiven. Therefore, confess your sins to one another and pray for one another that you may be healed. The fervent prayer of a righteous person is very powerful. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
easier, as we all know, when we're not feeling well, or when we ache or pain, or when we are in some kind of a depression or some kind of a state, to be by ourselves and feel sorry for ourselves, or me. You know, why is this happening to me? You know, why am I the only one who's got this kink in my back? You know, and why am I the only one who had this bad diagnosis? And why am I the only one who's not loved? We also know all of that kind of stuff. You know, how easy it is to fall in the trap of feeling sorry for ourselves. And then we, you know, sit there and wonder, you know, what happened? You know, why did God forget me? Well, what we need to do is to do what we've been instructed to do, to come together, to pray with one another, to lay hands on each other, and to let God's grace and God's mercy work in our lives. And that's exactly what we'll do this morning. You know, we'll allow God's mercy to work in our lives through these sacraments. Sacraments of anointing of the sick, and Eucharist that we will share, so that we will leave here, you know, and if we came in with a kink in our back, maybe the kink will be there when we go home, but we'll at least know that, you know what, I'm not the only one in the world who's got a kink in their back, or a bad knee, or this or that, you know. But if we would have stayed home by ourselves, we would have spent the rest of the time thinking that, well, everybody else's life is wonderful, and ours isn't. And also, we will have the opportunity to know that we are in communion with one another. You know, as we have been all our lives, you know, in communion with one another and with our God. That's the blessing of the sacrament. That's why we allow God's grace and God's mercy to work in our lives. I would say that probably everyone here has at one time or another been to a doctor of one kind or another. You know, whether it's for our toes or our teeth or our insides or our limbs or whatever the case might be. Well, today we come in a special way for the doctor of our souls and our spirits, to let God's grace, you know, touch us and strengthen us and heal us and inform us. And just as John's disciples said, go ask him, are you the one? And he says, go back and tell John, things are changing. You know, the deaf are hearing, and the blind are seeing, and the poor have the good news proclaimed to them, and people are being raised from the dead. So let John decide for himself, yeah, I am the one. And as we experience the presence of God's Spirit in our lives today, that we leave convinced that God is the one, and God is with us, and His Spirit is alive and well. We're going to bless the oil that we will use, and then our four priests will come up amongst us. They will lay hands on your head, and then they will anoint you on the forehead, on the palm of your hands. You know, your response at the time that they're in front of you is amen to the blessing of your forehead and the blessing of your hands. It's just a time to let ourselves be soaked in God's grace. I'd ask that we stand as we bless this oil that is created, God, for our sisters and brothers, and for all those who devote themselves to caring for them. Bless and fill our brothers and sisters with new hope and strength. Lord, have mercy. Relieve their pain. Lord, have mercy. Free them from sin and do not let them give way to temptation. Lord, have mercy. Sustain all the sick with your power. Lord, have mercy. Assist all who care for the sick. Lord, have mercy. Give life and health to our brothers and sisters on whom we lay our hands in your name. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
And praise to you, God, the Almighty Father. You sent your Son to live among us and bring us salvation. Blessed be God who heals us in Christ. And praise to you, God, the only begotten Son. You humbled yourself to share in our humanity, and you heal our infirmities. Blessed be God who heals us in Christ. Praise to you, God, the Holy Spirit, the Counselor. Your unfailing power gives us strength in our bodily weakness. Blessed be God who heals us in Christ. God of mercy, ease the sufferings and comfort the weakness of your servants whom the Church anoints with this holy oil. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Father in heaven, through this holy anointing, grant our sisters and brothers comfort in their suffering. When they are afraid, give them courage. When afflicted, give them patience. When dejected, afford them hope. And when alone, assure them of the support of your holy people. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
If our gifts can be brought up, we'll continue with you.
Jesus, heal.
Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, our Almighty Father. Be pleased, O Lord, to enkindle our hearts with the celestial fire of your Spirit, just as you granted that St. Alphonsus should celebrate these mysteries, and by them offer himself to you as a loyal sacrifice, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
And let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For in the marvelous confession of your saints, you make your church fruitful with strength ever new, and offer us sure signs of your love. And that your saving mysteries may be fulfilled, their great example lends us courage, and their fervent prayers sustain us in all we do. And so, Lord, with all the angels and saints, we too give you thanks as in exultation we acclaim.
Our Pope and Daniel, our Bishop, and all the clergy.
have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your grace. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, and Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all of the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs of eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen. 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 Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, I leave you peace, my peace I give you. Look not on our sin, but on the faith of your church. Graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Peace of the Lord be with you always.
Amen.
Let us share with one another the sign of Christ's peace. Let us collect our prayer. O God, only support of our human weakness, show the power of your protection over your servants who are sick, that sustained by your merciful help, they may be restored to your holy church in good health. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord is with you.
Amen.
Let us bow our heads and ask for God's blessing. May the God of all consolation bless you in every way and grant you hope all the days of your life.
Amen.
May God restore you to health and grant you salvation.
Amen.
May God fill your hearts with peace and lead you to eternal life.
Amen.
May Almighty God bless us, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Let us go now and glorify the Lord with our lives.